It's time.
She's spilling the tea.
This is the Rumor Report with Angela Yee on The Breakfast Club.
Yes, so somebody just bid $240,000. That all-in challenge is the fundraiser started by Michael Rubin, who is co-owner of the Philadelphia 76ers and founder of Fanatics, a sports apparel company. Proceeds from this fundraiser go towards fighting food insecurity amid the coronavirus pandemic and other charities as well. And for $240,000, somebody just won a double date with Russell Wilson and Ciara. So that's going to be, I guess, pretty fun for them, right? To go on a double date. There's a lot of amazing things.
Of money for a double date, though. What are we doing for that double date for that price?
I don't know. But you know what? I mean, clearly these are people that would be donating to charity and they're getting something from it, you know, for being able to hang out with Tom Brady and go to dinner or work out with him in his first game with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Right now, that price is up to $775,000, and bidding for that experience ends tomorrow. So that's a lot of
money. I mean, it's dope if you're a super fan of one of those people. If you're a super fan of Russell Wilson, a super fan of Ciara, or a super fan of Tom Brady, that's dope. But if you're just doing that just to do it, I would love to know why.
Well, maybe to donate money. You know, because you're like, all right, I'm going to donate money, so I might as well do it through this charity and win this auction and get something from it, perhaps. You know, they have a Kevin Durant dinner, courtside seats, and NCAA Player of the Year trophy. That's $65,000. And then there's things that you can bid on that are just $10 that are actually raffle entries to win other prizes as well. So it goes from $10 up to almost $775,000 right now. All right. Tyler Perry is working on a way to reopen his Atlanta studios safely. So what they're trying to do right now is he'll make sure that everybody gets tested. Everybody who tests negative would be invited on the lot. And that's when they will live there during the entire production. The cast and crew will check in the first day of filming. If they test negative, then they get to live there during that production.
That's
smart. They said that facility used to be an army base, as you know, so there's 141 barracks on site. All of them are usable. There's also 40 historic houses that you can live in. And Tyler Perry also built 30 houses on the lot for various productions, and all of them are functional. So they said if this can happen, then the cast and crew can use those facilities, which also includes a gym, a bar, and restaurants.
That's smart, man.
That's good. I would rather people, you know, figure out ways to try to keep people employed, especially if you can, you know, safely contain the situation.
And that's one of them. I mean, once you're on there, you can't leave. Everything you need is on there, on that lot. So
absolutely.
You're good.
Absolutely. Right, nobody got to get fired. No.
You can't leave. You know, that's it. Come in. You test negative. You can't leave. All right. Good to go.
Yep. Nobody get fired. Nobody get furloughed. I love that.
Yep.
All right. Scarface has given an update on his health, but that's after his battle with coronavirus, where he said he was inches away from death. He was on a Zoom chat with Willie D, and here's what he had to say.
I got to change my entire diet. I got to do dialysis 4 days a week. You know, before the COVID, I never had kidney. So I could not go to the hospital with COVID because I didn't want them to put me on a ventilator. You know, everybody putting on ventilators is dying, bro. So that 3 weeks, that month that I did in my house was like hell, bro. I couldn't keep food down. I couldn't get comfortable. I couldn't sleep. I couldn't stay woke. And like I said, I couldn't breathe, bro.
Wow. So he's going to change his whole diet now. And imagine having to go through that constantly. You know, he said he does dialysis 4 days a week, three hours a day. They take all his blood out, clean it, and then put it back in.
Wow.
Yeah, that's my guy. I check on Face every couple of days. And last time I spoke to him a few days ago, he definitely was in the hospital. Said the same exact thing. He's getting dialysis for his kidneys. But Face is a strong brother, man. You know, he's been through worse. So he'll get through this.
Now, Andy Cohen is speaking out. He actually wanted to donate plasma. And that's because he also had coronavirus. But he said that he couldn't. Now, here's the reason why you can't, or why Andy Cohen can't.
I signed up for a program for COVID-19 survivors where you could donate plasma to those still battling the virus. I was told that due to antiquated and discriminatory guidelines by the FDA to prevent HIV, I am ineligible to donate blood because I'm a gay man. Even the new relaxed rules require gay men to abstain from sex for 3 months, whether they're in a monogamous relationship or not, before giving blood. though no such blanket restrictions exist for people of other sexual orientations.
I don't get that. If they doing HIV if they doing HIV screenings on the blood, what does it matter? What does it matter if a person is gay or not?
Yeah, that doesn't make sense to me either.
Yeah, clearly these are very old, antiquated, discriminatory guidelines and that people are having to abide by. And right now they need to update that because that's ridiculous. Imagine you're trying to do something that can help people and you're being told that you can't even help others because of this discrimination.
Yeah, it shouldn't matter. If they do an HIV screening on the blood, that's it. Like either their blood is HIV positive or it's not. Simple.
All right, I'm Angela Yee, and that is your Rumor Report.